What's up, everybody? Jason here from JaspysCaseBreaks.com. We just sold out 2020 Topps Update Baseball doubleheader, number three, where it's one hobby case and one jumbo case, total of 18 boxes, which is a random team break, guys. And again, this includes a 6-box case of jumbo and a 12-box case of update hobby. Remember, all teams are in, veteran commons are donated, but all rookies, inserts, short prints, and numbered cards and hits will ship for your team/teams. So here you go. Here's the dice roll. Here's the customer names that bought in. Andrew down to I, and then from Ryan down to Shannon got those in Absolute Blaster 5. There you go. So let's roll the dice. And it's 2 and a 3 5 times. Good luck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 times. Josh, down to Josh. There you go, 5 times. Right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pittsburgh Pirates down to the Texas Rangers. Alright, so Josh, you have the Pirates, I with the Royals. Paul, you have the Braves, Oliver with the Astros, Fred with the Cubs, Josh with the Marlins, Josh Fleming, that is. Josh S. with the Dodgers, Andrew with the Rays, Jared with the Giants, Josh with the White Sox, Eric with the D-backs, Talon with the Yankees, I with the A's, Matthew with the Blue Jays, and all ready for trade. Wow, one Bo Bichette. Mark with the Indians, Rick with the Brewers, Josh with the Phillies, Shannon with the Padres, Thomas with the Cardinals, Ryan Harrell with the Reds, Anthony with the Nationals, Derek with the Twins, Shannon with the Tigers, Mike with the Rockies, Shannon with the Orioles, Josh with the Red Sox, Richard with the Angels, SKS with the Mets, Shannon with the Mariners, and Josh with the Rangers. Alright guys, so if anybody wants to trade, I'll give you guys a minute. What I'm going to start doing though, guys, is I'm going to start ripping this.
America's best. Book an exam online today at America's.
How come you want to trade Bo Bichette, Matthew? You must hate the Blue Jays. There must be a reason for this. Oh, so that's it? You're already, you're a Bo Bichette out? Alright, Matt, you might literally be one of the only two people watching. Alright, what I'm gonna start doing though, guys, I'll turn on Nick Cam. I'm gonna just start ripping this box, or case open, I should say. Nice, Matthew. There you go. You got your Tigers. So we're going to do this trade, guys. Tigers for Blue Jays. I know you probably literally will. All right, then, guys. Cool. I pulled one actually, Stitchy. I pulled one on the Instagram channel last week. It's pretty cool. All right, guys. We got one trade, guys. One trade. So I have the jumbo case right here, guys, and we're going to start off with the hobby boxes. So I'm going to try to skim through it. I'll pull out the main rookies, of course, like Bo Bichette, Yordan Alvarez, Rosarena. And, of course, the good thing about the update is that all the short prints are flipped backwards. So, if I do miss any, the shipping team, of course, is still going to go through these cards because they have to sort it out with what ships and what doesn't. And they are looking for the codes in the back. So, just in case I were to miss any, do not worry. But I did a lot of these, guys. I mean, I didn't do update, but I was I went to Dallas to do the Topps $1 million card rip party back in February before the shutdown, and I still have a little nightmares. But I broke about like 18 cases of hobby and jumbo together in like 12 hours. I was averaging like 45 minutes a case, and it was brutal. I was so exhausted that night. But it was a pretty fun experience. I got to meet Pete Alonso and be surrounded by other great breakers participating in ripping a million cards open for tops. It's pretty cool too. We were at AT&T Stadium where the Cowboys play. It was definitely a whole day event. I think what I'm gonna do, guys, is I'm gonna legit just pack stack this myself. And I'll show you guys this right here. First, Zach Gallen, Shohei Ohtani, Wilson Contreras, and Travis Demeritt. Jonathan Daza, Brock Burke, Tommy Edman, and Bruce Dark Gratterall. The thing I'm going to do is I'm going to rip open four boxes at a time. We'll go through the four boxes. And then once we kill the first hobby case, we'll jump over and end it with a jumbo as well. I know, Matthew, I was very surprised that that was the one that didn't sell out, but I'm also very happy that we actually got almost everything done. And for that, you know, I'm extending the promo for you guys, so that clearly were to not fill tonight by 1 o'clock when I'm done with this. I'm just going to call it a night. We'll extend that promo for tomorrow, and Joe will do that last break, and then... And give away that break credit for you guys. Yeah, I'm really surprised. I mean, dude, honestly, clearly it was such a great personal box break, though. I'll tell you that. Like, on Instagram, night one, we did, like, almost four master cases. Like, we did a lot. And I was very shocked that we did that much. And the case breaks took a little longer than I expected. But I think it makes sense because it was under a $400 box for a 1920 NBA. That was like a no-brainer for people, you know? Sonny Gray, Zach Gallen, Shohei Ohtani, Wilson Contreras. Yeah, for sure, man. And it's a lot of repeats, but then that's what also makes me want to, like, run pick your teams, and because you're going to get multiples of the same player, which is great. I mean, it's not a bad thing. Not bad to get a couple Jaws, you know, a couple of these rookies where you can just continue to grow the rookies that you have with them. But with Immaculate, I don't know why, but I'm feeling like that Immaculate is such a great deal picker team wise. And those RPAs out of there are going to sell for bonkers. So, but, and then I also have a feeling that Immaculate is going to be such a great personal break. I think someone's going to rather just buy a box outright. And hit drafts, I think, are going to be very good on personals. So, if you guys are looking for hit drafts on Immaculate Basketball on Wednesday with me, it's going to be bonkers. I guarantee you. I don't even know what a box of Immaculate is retailing for. But I expect it to sell pretty well. I know the price point of the Pelicans are scary at $3,000, and the Memphis Grizzlies guys, but you know a Jaw RPA is going to go for more than that probably. If the true NT RPAs were going for like 60 to 70,000 for Zion and like 20 to 40,000 for Ja Morant, a $2,000 price point is scary to buy, but you got to think that Immaculate RPAs are going to go for at least minimum 10 for Ja, at least minimum 20 for Zion probably. I mean, it has to. It just only makes sense. Especially with basketball season almost around the corner basically too. Wednesday's a draft night. People are going to be like, ooh, Pelicans drafted this guy. Pelicans traded for this person. Grizzlies added this person. And then there you go all over again. People are going to continue to buy their rookies. Because they're going to get so pumped for the season. So Immaculate should be a very fun product. Dude, Drew Holiday was traded for 3 first-round picks and a couple players. That's ridiculous. The Pelicans just came up so good. Drew Holiday was not worth that much. But I guess nowadays, people are willing to give up draft picks for instant impact, right, and talent because they're proven, right? It's not like any other sport where you're not investing so much for a first-round pick in the NBA. How many draft day trades there always are, you know? That's ridiculous, though. But, yeah, Drew's a great player. I'm not trying to say that Drew is not a good player, but I don't know if he was that amazing for 3 first-round picks. I mean, hell, I don't even think the Lakers... I think the Lakers barely gave the Pelicans 3 first-round picks for Anthony Davis. But then again, I know they did give Lonzo Ball and Brandon Ingram. And like Josh Hart, but I don't know. I that's what I'm just trying to say. Hell, 3 first round picks for Anthony Davis as well, I want to say. I don't know. I think I'd rather have Anthony Davis. But I guess you have to factor in Brandon Ingram and Lonzo and stuff like that, but yeah, the Bucks are definitely desperate, for sure. Definitely. Oh, yeah. If for some reason Mahomes were to ever be traded, yes, he's... I mean, the fact that... Imagine if a Mahomes can actually be put on the trade block. Like, the Chiefs like, you know what? We've already won, like, 4 Super Bowls with this dude. We're done. We're just going to invest in the future now. And we're going to trade him at the prime of his career, like, 29 years old. Someone's going to trade their whole franchise, right? And be like, yeah, I'll give you the Lions. I'll give you the Lions for Patrick Mahomes. Boba Chet. There you go. And Brock Burke, rookie. Texas Rangers. No, but seriously though, what do you think Patrick Mahomes will get traded for? He would have to get traded for a ton of draft picks and a ton of great talent. And I'd be so curious to know what people would trade for Mahomes. Actually, guys, I'm just going to rip open 6 boxes. I know, but it's not even about money. It's like, I mean, I guess it would be about money, right? We'll give you $500 million and our whole team for Patrick Mahomes. But no, that would just be the dumbest trade ever now. Even though he's only been in the league for like 4 years now. Imagine saying that, a dude that's only been in the league for his fourth year, technically third year playing because his first year he didn't play at all. We're talking about a whole ownership, a whole team would be worth the trade. That's amazing. That is scary. Like 1 year, MVP, lost an AFC championship. Next year, Super Bowl champion, Super Bowl MVP. I know, that's the one thing. Like, Casey did so good, and he was just sitting back. And I think of Tua, and, you know, it was kind of the same situation. Like, you know, I feel bad for Fitzgerald, but he was winning this year. He wasn't, like, bad. And then they decided to switch him for Tua. Like, I wonder what it would have been like if they actually did that with Mahomes. Like, all the fans' noise just said, you know what, fine, we're going to put in Patty. For reals. Yeah, Houston Texans are definitely... Knowing now that Bill O'Brien is fired now, knowing that this happened now, I think they would go back in time and not trade DeAndre Hopkins. I'll tell you that. They were watching last night what D-Hops is doing with Arizona and Kyler Murray, and Deshaun Watson was just probably drafting a text that I request a trade. Because it's not fair to him. Hell, they almost traded Will Fuller. They almost traded another speedy receiver for him before the trade block, but they didn't get it done. That's sad. Cody, Mike Trout, Gavin Lux, AJ Puck. Yeah, I like Alex Smith Stitch. I mean, good for him, man. I'm glad his career he turned it back up, and from what happened to him with his gruesome injury to now is amazing. Yeah. Well, you gotta hope that they're gonna promise and get Watson some help in the offseason and get him some talent around him. Because that dude has been troubled with injuries in college, and he's relatively stayed healthy. Besides, you know, that 1 year with his ACL. Dude, Brock Osweiler balled out for Denver for a couple years, or for 1 year, right? And then gets traded for a gazillion dollars. I mean, he did ball out for those couple games in that season. But that's kind of like me with my Eagles and Kevin Cobb. I don't know if you guys remember Kevin Cobb, but he did pretty well after McNabb, and they decided, fine, like, we're gonna pay you, we're gonna trade you, we're gonna keep you as our starter. And then Eagles got rid of him, and the Cardinals gave him so much money. Eagles got like a first and a second round pick for him, and he never did anything. Yeah, and then he got traded like back to Denver. Or I don't even know where. And they were also still paying him because it was part of the agreement. He was getting double checks. Oh, yeah. That's right. No, that's right. He ended up back in Houston at some point, right? He ended up somewhere back. I thought it was the Broncos eventually. Hey, but good for him. He got paid. The one player that's a quarterback that has just been stealing money from the NFL teams for very long is Chase Daniels. That dude was such a stud in college at Missouri. And he's been in the league for how long? And just has raked up like probably close to like 80 mil doing like being a backup his whole career. Jared, no, we don't have any 2020 Leaf mini helmets. I think eventually you guys are going to have to look for someone to take over for Matthew Stafford, right, Matthew? I mean, what's your 2 cents on that? I know lots of Lions fans that still love Matthew Stafford, but it's just, I think you have to start thinking elsewhere soon, right? Kind of been there just as long as, like, Andy Dalton was with the Bengals. About a year or two more, actually. Juan Soto, Kevin Biggio, Fernando Tatis, and Josh Donaldson. Yeah. I feel you, man. Alright. First 6 boxes, guys. Kevin Lux, rookie. Boba Shett. Suzo Zardo, Kyle Lewis. And Xander Bogaerts to 76. Lewis. Buster Posey, that must be a short print. Very nice. And I don't think I showed you guys the list. But Giants going to Derek. Nico. Jordan. Russell Martin? Jackson with Willie. Oh. That's good for the score. The Ravens. You know? Cortez, foil rookie. Twenty, Francisco Lindor. And a relic of Jose Altuve. Next box. Gavin Lux. Bichette. 2020, Brian Johnson. Cuthbert. Nico. Is the seven wild card? She only gets wild card. Eddie gets a spot in the league. There you go, Eddie. Don't get mad, get it true, and get more than just trimble. Investing, banking, fun. Rookie Poppin, foil. Miguel Cabrera, $2.99. Decade's best batters. There you go, Detroit Tigers for Matthew. Bartolo Colon. Piece of the jersey, maybe? 6 out of 25. That's New York Mets, Bartolo Colon. Mets going to SKS. Only from iRobot. Mookie Betts foil. Yordan, Mookie, Randy, a Rosarena. That's our first sighting right there. Our next box. Gavin Lux. Foil Mike Logan Webb. Or Ryan Weber. Bo Bichette. Jesus Lizardo, Kyle Lewis. Randy or Rosarena. Trent Grisham, we got a sharp print. There you go for the Padres. Well, Shannon, there you go, man. I'm going to probably call it a night after this, Kyle, but do not worry. I was telling people that since you guys pretty much got everything else done besides that break, we're extending the promo to tomorrow. So Joe will break that for you guys. And he'll run the promo tomorrow if that's the case. Labor Torres relic. No problem, man. I mean, like, I wasn't gonna extend it, but like about an hour ago or so, a little bit more than that, we got like three of the promo breaks done out of the four. Like NT sold, the Panini one sold, this break sold, and I was just like, all right, guys, you guys did some major work then. Clearly, we're to not go then. We'll give you guys that extra day. So those teams will probably be sold pretty quickly tomorrow. Thank you. 2020. Bartolo Colon. Jordan. Alright guys, three more boxes and then we'll be halfway through the first case. Like I said, this hobby break will probably take me the longest. Jumbo is a little bit quicker. Devin Williams. Gavin Lux. To 300. Austin Allen. Boba Chet. And wow, Ichiro, sharp print for the Mariners. Wow, is that your second sharp print? Two for two so far. Song Castro. Randy. Oh. Libertadores foil. /2020 Kyle Lewis, very nice. Mariners. Going to Shannon. Relic. Anthony Rizzo to /199. Cubs, Fred. Next box. Arce does Aquino. Ty France. Really? You think so? There has been a lot of Bartolos than usual. Andrew McCutcheon, decades best. No, but I'm with you too, man. Like, why Bartolo? Have there been a couple of hits of him? That's just a weird one. Yordan. Zach Green foil. Randy. Yeah, that one was really cool. Lux. Boba Shett. Max Scherzer. Thank you. Lux. Anthony Rizzo. Which one? Did I miss one? Why wasn't it flipped backwards? Oh, wait, are you talking about the one I already pulled? Wait, the first one that I already did? The last one, right? Oh, yeah. Was that like a third variation or something? The teacher right here? Scared me, Matt. I was like, what? I was like, I know I didn't miss one. Alright, sorry about that, guys. Alright, last box here, guys, and then we'll go with the next six. Shohei Ohtani. A little like a violet or purple border. Aquino. Lizardo and Kyle Lewis just literally come together like Jordan Bone and John Morant. To 69, Zach Greinke. Little black border. Do these still sell well, guys? The black borders? I remember back in the day, those ones go for a lot. And it feels like a rookie black border. Crazy. Oh, they still do if they're rookies? Nice. I mean, they only made 69 of them, so I feel like they have to be worth something. Yeah, Maddie, Hobby's the killer one. Hobby's the killer one. I feel like I'm going at a great pace. Like, I can only imagine Joe was, like, dying when he did this. Like I said, it just brings me back nightmares when I had to do, like, 18 cases of this stuff in one night. I did well. I think I started crashing, like, in the last, like, 4 hours. Like, I did great the first 6-7 hours, but I remember getting to, like, case number, like, 13 or something. I was dead already. Boba Chat. My beard is growing. I know, they do. Like I said, I wanted to get the Hobby done first. I feel like the Hobby is the real killer one. Only one relic or auto, which is kind of a drag. But it is much cheaper, of course. But once we get to the jumbo case, I think that one would be much more exciting. And let's put the three hits. And it's only 6 boxes. Although there is probably just as many cards as a box and a half of this. Maybe 2 boxes, but... for me, it goes by much quicker. But I'm very curious now. How long did Joe take to do his case? 2 cases. By himself. If he had to do them by himself. Joe's probably going to be so upset if he woke up tomorrow and seen that this break was going to happen with him. You think he's had to do like the first two. Clayton Kershaw. 2 hours and... Oh, man. Honestly, I'm kind of underestimating this one. I forget Hobby's going to take me like an hour and a half probably. And Jumbo takes me about 45 minutes to an hour. So actually, I might take just as long as him probably. I'm at the hour mark right now, and I've done half a Hobby. And I think the first like 10 minutes was randomizing and trade windows and stuff. And then of course, I think the last like 40 minutes or so have been just ripping and going through the boxes. So if I could do this in 30 minutes, get this done in an hour and a half, then I can definitely get the other break done within 45 minutes to an hour. But this is also the reason why, guys, I wanted this to be the last box, because I see there's only about 14 of us watching now. And I think people were like, yeah, I'm going home. I'm going to sleep. So I'm glad that. Glad that we almost got everything done. Was it really? Was somebody pack stacking for him? Ah, see, he had Nick helping. So there hasn't been any of them that he did by himself? Check number one or number two, Matthew. If he had someone helping, that's much quicker. Thank you, Arturo. I know, man. I need you guys to keep me up. I might fall asleep breaking this. Why? He had two. Yeah, he had make help for both of them. Okay. Well, okay, that's my goal then. Although I don't think I'm gonna be able to get it done in 2 hours and 5 minutes, but I'll try to get it done within that time frame. Trent Grisham rookie, Nick Castellanos, Jordan Alvarez, and Steven Strasburg. Out of 75 box.
Andrew.
Luis Robert, very nice. Ronald Acuna Jr., Michael Brosell, Jesus Luzardo. Oh, we just have to do that one more break, Jensen, but like I told people, for selling everything out but the clearly authentic or clearly Donruss, I'm extending that promo until tomorrow. So once that break sells out tomorrow, Joe will break it for you guys, and then he will run the promo. So this will be my last break of the night. It's going to take me about 2.5 hours, so Joe will run that last break for you guys whenever it sells out tomorrow, and then he'll run the promo for you guys. Yeah, it's Shane Bieber, Anthony Rendon, and Yoshi. Yeah, we're close, Matthew. It'll happen tomorrow. I think I'm going to tap out after this. I'll also let Joe just handle the promo. Appreciate you guys. I mean, I wasn't gonna extend it, but then you guys sold out like 3 straight breaks, which gave me no choice, man. You guys put in the work. We sold out Panini One, we sold out NT, and then we sold this breakout. So you guys put in the work. You guys get rewarded. So just have to sell it out completely tomorrow, and then can get that promo done for you guys tomorrow. Thank you. What's that?
Carlos, the guy about the black gold off, gold auto offer.
Which one?
The mosaic.
Oh, gotcha. Yeah, yeah.
He's in the chat. He goes, "Bro, did you see what that last one just sold for, Ross?"
No.
I was like, "No." He goes, "It was listed for $14,000 or best offer.
Uh-huh.
Offer accepted at $8,000.
That's crazy.
I was like, "What?"
Yeah.
I was like, "You're joking, right?" He goes, "No, I swear to God."
Yeah, because the one was like over 10, so that makes sense.
How dumb is that, though?
Yeah.
I was like, man.
Sell it.
Well, no, he's like, dude, you need to get yours graded. He's like, that
yeah,
thing
you should,
was,
actually.
He's like, that thing was so clean.
Yeah. It should. Oof. All right, guys, last box of ripping the hobby, and then we'll go through the six boxes. Seth Brown, Derek Jeter, Tony Gonsolin, and Willie Castro, rookie, for Detroit, number to 199. Six boxes, guys. Whew. Let's do this. Bad Bonnie. I must have heard this like at least six times already within the last hour. You know. McGuire. Lux, Boba Shett, Mariano Rivera, Yankees, on a Talon, Trent Grisham, Trevor Ariza. There's a cut. There's cut signatures in this. And is that a real odd? What you just literally put? I wouldn't be surprised if they actually made that many packs. Jordan, Luis Robert. Is it weird that I felt? Ooh, Rosa Reina foil. Is it weird that Anna back to back regular? Is it weird that I've only felt like I've only pulled like one Luis Robert rookie, or is that just normal in this? Foil. Making me think like I missed some probably. Yeah, it's gonna sit there for years. And we're talking like 20, 30 years. Debbie Williams. Nolan. Nice. No, I just feel like out of all the other rookies, I've gotten at least one of those big rookies per box, except for like Jordan. Rosa Reina, I didn't pull one in the first box, but I think I pulled one in the next couple. Cano. Kelly Johnson. Is he a shorter print than everybody else? Just feel like he is. Wow. What a break for Shannon. Not only getting an Ichiro short print, but also getting a Kyle Lewis. Man, that's like three short prints for him already. Seattle Mariners, he got a short print. That's two of them already, actually. What was the other short print he got? Oh, yeah, he got the Giants, Buster Posey, I believe. No, that was Derek. Grisham is what he got, actually. That is crazy. What a break for you, buddy. Yeah, that was Bartol. Out of 50, Drew Smiley. Bichette and a Randy or Rosarena. Devin Williams. Out of 69, Logan Morrison. Oh, there's prospects in this too? Like, it'll say prospect, not rookie or something? Devin Williams? Cameron Maven, foil. Jordan. '85 design one? Gotcha. I'll look out for that, brother. Zach Davis. Cincinnati Red, Sonny Gray. Did he really? Budweiser should, man. Trevor Bauer is so funny on Twitter. All right, guys, next one. '20 Yachty. Williams.
They rushed for just 6 yards per game, converted less than a quarter of their third downs. After a bye week in week 11, they head to Lambeau. Meanwhile, the team started 1-5, don't look down. Suddenly, Kirk Cousins and the Vikings have a little momentum on their side. As the season goes on, you start to kind of figure out who you are.
Yoan Moncada to $2.99 for the White Sox. Yordan. And Sonny Gray relic. Verlander.
And now you got 3 games coming up against Dallas, Carolina, Jacksonville, all at home. They should be favored in all of those. The AFC is far more crowded than the NFC. We'll start with you. How likely is it Minnesota to have to win it because of the possible playoff?
Well, as long as they win the game that they're technically supposed to win, they continue to play to this formula, which is run the football if you can, protect the football at all costs, be good on third down, be good in the red area. Those are the things that they did tonight that we contributed to a win. If they can do this, they're not winning a lot of games in the NFL, Scotty. So, I mean, if they can continue to be that type of football team, then they have a good shot at it as anyone.
I think the most encouraging thing to come out of tonight was they didn't have their fastball. They didn't have the running game as they've had it in the past 2 games with Dalvin Cook, and they still found a way to win. And I think after those 3 weeks, let's say they do win the games, they're supposed to win, they'd be 7-5. And then they play the Bucs and the Saints in a course of 3 weeks, right?
Xbox. Devin Williams. Francisco Lindor short print for the Cleveland Indians going to Mark Owl. That's a cool one. Bo Bichette.
And there's no question, right? It's in the back of your mind. Every single time you play in prime time, they're going to say, they said, no, you're not winning the big game. So he won that playoff game a couple of years back. So I think he's in a
Lizardo, Kyle Lewis.
He's in a good spot, and I think he's with the Minnesota Vikings. He has a team that supports him and surrounds him with the talent he needs to be effective.
I think we're going forever. The quarterbacks get too much blame. He gets too much credit. And Kirk knows that. He has tremendous self-awareness. He understands how people look around him and view his career through. And he did it through wins or losses in big moments.
Andrew McCutcheon. Or sorry, Andrew Kisner. Or Kinsner.
Otherwise, he wouldn't have the reaction that he had at the end of his football game. He knew how big it was. He knew what it means for them setting up down the floor in the next 3 weeks. The quarterback of the Bucs, the gentleman knows this. Mike Zimmer knows exactly what he wants to be as a team. And he has his team play that way, good or bad. So we know what we're going to get from the Vikings going forward. We'll see how it plays out.
I was close with Chicago.
Finally, we got our first auto.
I think we all understood 5-1.
Andrew Knapp.
Was a bit of smoke and mirrors. And we've seen since that Rams game.
Phillies.
And the same problems that plagued that offense when we talked after that Rams game continued to be evident. And I just don't know if you alluded to it during the game. That these are problems that are fixed during the season. So understanding that, I guess how do you go forward and what do you do if you're the Bears?
Well, so I'll see you guys in a minute.
It's gonna start with Matt Nagy, the head coach. He's gonna have to somehow find a way to keep his players engaged on the defensive side in particular, and find a way to continue to grind on offense and try to find solutions that allow them to have chances to win football games. As bad as their output was tonight, they had a chance to win this football game in the Bowls. It's Anthony Miller down the middle of the football field. And if they throw that and they win this football game, we're going, man, that's an ugly
one. Roll this Chapman.
So, it's hard to pick your football team off of losing a game like this. When you meet with them on Tuesday, tomorrow, and go on Wednesday, since it's a short week for them, and get them ready to go once again. That's tough. That calls on your professionalism, and hopefully they have enough of them in that locker room to keep you going. They had two turnovers in the game. They missed the kick for a touchdown. They completely dominated special teams and on defense, and they still didn't win. I mean, what? There is no coming back from
Bryce Harper.
After losing four straight, and this is going to be a brutal 2 weeks for Matt Nagy and this team, and it's not going to get any easier. Coming out of the bye, they're going to play the Packers in Lambeau. This is not going to be pretty.
Well, it is tough, but I mean, this is the reality. You guys have lived it. You know the highs and the lows of the NFL. We're looking forward to next week, a really good game between the Rams and the Buccaneers. Travel well, stay safe, and we'll talk to you next week in Tampa. All right, fellas?
Scotty, kudos to you. You know, a week in Augusta, and right there Monday, you're right back at it, pal.
Hey, I'm just happy to have a game, man. I appreciate that. We're having a lot of games.
Alright guys, two more boxes of hobby. We're almost there. And then the jumbo case is much quicker, guys. I'm at the hour and 30 minute mark, guys, but for like the first 10, like 15 minutes or so, almost 20, we're just doing the trades and randomizers and stuff. I at least killed like a 15 minutes there, so an hour and 15 or so. Hour and 20 for the full hobby by myself is not too bad, I don't think so. Except for the most part, I think I've caught everything. I'm sure the shipping team will find stuff though, but. And I'm penny sleeving and top loading most of the stuff. Wow. Another Ichiro short print. This definitely is a Mariners break.
They had to make a dramatic improvement of bringing an impact player to this team. Drew Holiday fits Milwaukee.
Crazy.
Both sides of the ball. This is a tremendous, impactful deal for them. And especially after they lost Dennis Schroeder and were back in the market for a guard, they got an even better one in Drew Holiday.
Alright, so that's a big time trade. Yeah. We got news later that you broke about another one and another star who'd like to be part of almost every year. Thanks, guys.
We got Derek Jeter, 20 years of the captain. Yankees. It's going to Talon.
Carlos.
2020. And go. Giancarlo Stanton. Short print. Alright, last box here, and then we'll go on to the jumbos. Randy Arozarena. Nico. Tomas Nido. '70s Red Sox. Chat. Mike Trout, 2020. Jordan Alvarez. But think about what you
Sean Payton's tutelage. I think that this team could be really good still. They still have a great opportunity.
All right, Coolio. Alright guys, so Jumbo Edition, you get one autograph and two relic cards in every hobby box, and you get three packs, including the patch pack, which is pretty awesome, actually. What I'll do is I'll save these towards the end. We'll leave those right there. Let's just start ripping this. Three at a time.
Definitely needed. I think the cost is the next step to that. Now, typically, you know.
All right. Alright, let's do this, guys. Good luck. Arsenio Zucchino. And New York Yankees, 20 years of the captain, Derek Jeter. Clayton Kershaw, gold foil. Dale Murphy, decades best. Andy Burns. Keston. Fulmer gold foil. Nate Pearson. Randy Arozarena. And our autograph here is Josh James for the Astros. Houston going to Oliver. Bryce Wilson.
It is Charles, but if they go up by 10, they probably win, right? But if they don't score, they definitely win because
Mark Black.
And if you go up by 10, then some people would have been happy. You almost certainly would have won. But as we learn, inaction almost certainly doesn't mean for sure.
Bo Bichette, and I feel like this has to be a short print, right? It wasn't flipped backwards, but I haven't seen this one in a while. Yeah, it has to be a Bo Bichette short print. I don't know if it's a super, super short print. Who knows, but definitely a short print right there. And Shannon, what a break for you, buddy. See, Matthew, my eyes are still good, man. Once I see too many of the same cards, then that's when you can catch the short prints. And wow, what about this one right here? Another Derek Jeter. Christian Yelich short print. Haggerty.
Haggerty.
Oh my god, what the hell? Elvis Andres. Big Poppy. Donovan Solano. And /199 baseball stars, Scott Heineman. Texas Rangers going to Josh Fleming. Wander Franco. All right, last box here, and then we got three more guys. We're almost there. Another Derek Jeter, this time 1 out of 50.
Thank you.
Wow. Wow, what a case. What a break. I hardly got any Luis Roberts, but we got a Luis Roberts short print right here. This is sick. Josh with the Chicago White Sox. What a break.
Is it the signing or? Oh.
That's him with like that.
Yeah. That's a cool one.
Lux. What do you mean? What do you mean by that, Matthew? Todd Frazier. Wait, like, are you saying Edwin Encarnacion has the same, a similar one, Matthew, or that's Edwin Encarnacion? Because I mean that, I don't. That looks like Luis Robert. Or he has a similar one that looks the same. Okay, so Edwin has a base like that, but Luis has a short print like that? Gotcha. Makes sense, easy. I hardly pull anything, just like the retro stuff. I'm so lost, Matthew. I don't know what you mean by that. Jarrell Cotton. Oh, so they're the same serial number, so they're both U173. Sorry, I've been breaking this for 2 hours already. Chris Bryant. I got you. AZ clarified it for me. But does that make a significance or what? Is that just something that they messed up on or something? And we got baseball star autographs. Dario Agrazo.
Style, but both Arizona backs ready to play. team that loses from the standpoint that you're kind of freer when you didn't get the win to explore more possibilities and maybe make more adjustments? Have you given that any thought over the years, or do you have any mindset to that?
I haven't.
Gotcha. Alright guys, well, we are down to the last three boxes. I said ripping this is much, much quicker, so I figured that I would get done with this by like 2 hours and 30 minutes without pack stacking, so we are good. But I think I killed like 15-20 minutes though, doing some trades and randomizing, so kind of makes up right here. But I'm at 2 hours and 10 minutes right now exactly, with 3 boxes left. All right, last 3 boxes, guys. Sir.
Hit draft, spot 6, Tony.
Mm-hmm.
So this is one combo, is the relics. Out of 20, out of 50.
Okay.
Rookie auto pitcher, out of 25. And Salvador Perez, out of 50.
What, is he trying to pick or something?
Well, he's not here.
Oh. This is one, that's one, and that's a combo?
Mm-hmm. Mojo and...
I'd probably go with the patches, just because right? That's a nice patch. Yeah. I would probably go patches, too.
Okay. Because it's a rookie pitcher.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay. And then Salvador Perez.
Yeah, that's, yeah, yeah. Not worthy. Thank you, Izzy. I know, man. I mean, like I told people, I've done this before. It's just been a while since I've done a case like break like this. Back in February, I went to the Topps Million Card Rip Party. And me and Nick combined had to do like 18 cases in like 12 hours. It was rough. Of Series 1 Topps. A little brutal, but we made it. I think I'm doing pretty strong without any pack stacking. I'm pretty much there. And just imagine sorting 18 cases too. But I've done much faster, though, with this jumbo. The hobby one was the killer one. That one took me about, like, an hour and 40 minutes. This one's going to take me only, like, 45 minutes.
It's the last two boxes?
Yeah, he's the last three.
No. Boxes.
What's that?
The last two boxes.
Hmm? Well, yeah, one box, two box, and that'll be the third one.
Oh, each stack is one box.
Yeah. I've actually done this one pretty fast. The jumbo's always quicker. It's the hobby that's killer.
Don't let me help him.
Huh?
You don't let me help
him. Yeah. What?
You like need a screen for just the hands to come out.
I know. Last box, guys. So Joe, I actually had Nick help him with both breaks. I didn't realize it. He did this whole thing in 2 hours and 10 minutes. With Nick's help, I'm at 2 hours and 15. So if he had like no help on it, if I took like 2 hours and 45 minutes, probably longer, maybe 3 hours. Yeah, you're telling me. Yeah, it is. Is that in Mexico?
No, I think
or just a bakery here. Yeah, it's virtual. It's kind of in the NFL draft. All right, guys. Good luck. Last three boxes. Another Yankee. Okay, years of the captain. Derek Jeter. Brandon Davis. I love their segment every Monday. It's called Bad Beats.
Bad Beats?
Bad Beats, yeah. So, like, they do the gambling aspect of it where, like, they show you close games of, like I told you, the point spreads.
Oh, yeah.
And it's, like, how close it is for someone to win on one side, but then it just drastically changes and they lose. And then they show you, like, the over-under. Like, I told you how many total points. And they showed one earlier. That was so sad. It's going to come back to it right now again. If you stay and watch it. It was so funny.
What do you mean it changes so fast?
Because, like, it's, like, basically, like, you're about to cover. Like, you're about to win. And then all of a sudden, like, either someone scores or, like, there was a turnover. And then you lose.
Oh.
Domingo Leyva. Autograph for the Diamondbacks going to Eric.
We determine that the variations, they're like normal clothes.
Yeah, well, no, well, the one thing is that there's normal clothes, and then they're more zoomed in. So, like, if they're in an action photo, it's the opposite. They're, like, in the dugout or something. I found one that wasn't flipped over. But that's because Boba Fett was, like, a big popular one, and I've noticed that that's not what he looks like.
One of them, Kershaw, was, like, at a podium.
Yeah, yeah, well, that's what I'm saying. Stuff like that, where it's just, they're not in an action photo or something.
And then Pete Alonso was, like, in a suit.
Yeah. Like, Christian Yelich, she's like, in an interview, too, and he's, like, wearing a long sleeve or something.
Yeah.
But some of them, that's the first one I found that wasn't flipped backwards.
Why can't tops just have bigger fonts?
Oh, I don't know. There's another one, Aaron Judge.
I like that.
Mercer.
Mercer. Did not know that it rose Yankees.
Played for a lot of teams after Seattle. Played in Miami, the Yankees. He went back to actually Seattle, I think. Not Luis Robert.
Nice. 631.
Arcet is Aquino. Tomlin. Grisham foil. Randy or Rosarena.
Is there anybody chatting?
Barely. Just a couple people. Alfaro. We got a patch here of Eugenio Suarez. It's a nice patch. Red's going to Ryan. Harold, that's 3 out of 5. There you go.
You're going to need a shoebox.
Yeah, for the hits. Okay. Randy Arozarena. Was it always 2 monster boxes or was it more?
It was 2 monster boxes and a shoebox.
Oh. Rosarena. It's gonna be all pulp.
It's
Nolan Arenado.
It's a piece of the bat.
Yeah.
Just shave it.
Then we, yeah. Brennan McKay. Or David McKay, sorry. Grisham. Alvarez. Clayton Kershaw. And a Devin Williams, Rookie of the Year for the NL. Milwaukee Brewers. This one, no, it's the same dude all the time. I know, that's why Sam said some of the imagery kind of tricks you. Out of 69, Blandino. Another Derek Jeter. Trout foil. Gavin Lux. Grisham. Yordan Alvarez. Cabrera foil. Wander Franco, number one prospect for the Rays. Miguel Cabrera, 2020. Encarnacion gold foil. Jim Abbott. Yeah, the chrome ones, and then they have in the jumbo, they make one out of like material. It's pretty crazy.
Oh yeah, the sewn one.
Yeah, the silk ones. Out of 199 for the Angels, it's going to Richard Miller. Luis Robert, little 35th anniversary insert. Jordan, Arcides Aquino, Sandy Koufax to 299. Right, huh, Eric? I forgot about that guy. You're right. He was one-handed.
Oh my god.
Good catch, Eric. I totally forgot about that guy. Alright, guys. We are down to the final box.
That's a very nice signature.
Yeah. Can I really get another pen? Just one is fine. I remember seeing videos of that dude. I know who this guy is now. I remember seeing videos of this dude. And yeah, how quickly like he would switch right away, huh? Just to transition into grabbing the glove to taking it out and throwing it. It's pretty amazing.
streak going in week 11 against Dallas. Who is good at flying? Greasy joining me now. And gentlemen, the Minnesota Stars, and they're lousy. They're 1-5, moving home. It looks a mess, right? And now you got three games coming up against Dallas, Carolina, Jacksonville, all at home. They should be favored in all of those. The AFC is far more crowded than the NFC. Lewis, I'll start with you. How likely is it Minnesota throws their hat in the ring and becomes a possible playoff team?
Yeah, no, imagine that. Like, you have to switch hands really quick just to, like, make sure you don't get hit by a pitch. I totally forgot about that. Alrighty, guys, last box, and then we'll go through all of the packs over there to my right. Yordan Alvarez. Relic of Buster Posey.
Wait, do you want regulars or decks?
For what? No, I put those in.
This is supposed to be the thick ones? Because I gave you regulars.
All right, I reconnect. That was weird.
Do you want regulars?
That is regulars.
Okay.
Yeah.
I thought you wanted thick.
No. Thick's already have enough.
I definitely
You got a no-hitter? Really? That's crazy. Yeah, it was. Vladimir Guerrero. Jump 6, Washington Nationals. Francisco Lindor foil. Randy Arozarena. Another medallion relic. This time is Joe Girardi. Nico Sharprint. Cubs, that's going to Fred. You know, if you can do me a favor, can you give me some 55s so I can top load those little relics? And then when I do the recap, there should be. None? No, I don't need regulars. I need 55. Colson Wong. Eat your old foil.
There's one over here, yeah.
Devin Williams. Don't throw this over here. It's a hit.
I know that. That's awesome.
Trent Grisham. Aaron Bummer. A lot of draft picks in this deal because the Bucks didn't have to give up any of their core players. Nolan Jones. Eric Bledsoe won. I mean, Drew Holiday is a significant upgrade, and Eric and George Hill's in the deal, and he's something of a throw in his deal. So the three first round picks and two pick swaps, the price of those picks versus not signing Giannis Antetokounmpo, the Supermax extension that is on the table. However many picks are going to New Orleans, there's not going to be a Giannis in that group. They had to make a dramatic improvement of bringing an impact player to this team. Drew Holiday fits Milwaukee character-wise, both sides of the ball. This is a tremendous, impactful deal for them, and especially after they lost Dennis Schroeder and were back in the market for a guard, they got an even better one in Drew Holiday. Fractured some ribs and collapsed lung.
Oh my god.
Alright guys, let me quickly just top load this stuff. We'll go with the packs here and then I'll do a little recap and I'll probably make a separate video. I won't make you guys watch this whole video or scroll down.
Anybody penny slipped?
No. Those are just the last space cards.
You gonna go through these too?
Probably not. All right, cool, y'all. Let's do it. We got a Trevor Story. Very nice. Kevin Biggio, Fernando Tatis, Josh Donaldson, Sonny Gray. Zach Gallen, Shohei Ohtani, Wilson Contreras, Travis Demeritt. Chris Bryant. Unifier. Castellanos, Yordan Alvarez rookie, Cody Bellinger, Mike Trout. Gavin Lux rookie, AJ Puck, Juan Soto, and Roger Clemens number. $2.99. Buster Posey. Oh my god, did you really do that, Brad? I don't I've never That's crazy. Roger Clemens, Hyunjin Ryu, Ravello, Seth Brown. Derek Jeter, Gonsolin, Luis Roberts. Ronald Acuna Jr. You got Alex Bregman. I think these are so cool. You know what happened probably is the he landed right on the football. And that's what probably messed up his ribs too. Oops. Cabrera. Rhys Hoskins, George Springer, Bobby Bradley, and Zach Gallen. Altuve, man, a lot of Houston Astros. Dude, these are so cool. I love these.
I think I heard Sean say somebody was collecting them to make a blanket.
That'd be cool. Cool. Alright, a couple more, guys. Bo Bichette, Yonder Than Daza, Burke, Tommy Edman. Bruce Argratero, Shogo, Dale Murphy, Stoutman. Alright, this is the last jumbo. Eloy Jimenez for the White Sox. The bad beats is after this. Alright, last two packs. Wilson Contreras, Travis Demeritt, Mariano Rivera, and Garrett Cole Blue. At a 150. And there you go, guys. So in a separate video, I'll have a little hit recap for you guys. So that way you guys don't have to scroll through about 2 hours and 42 minutes of this. But there was no randomizers to do. At least I don't think so. And my computer's going to be a little slow right now. But yeah, you guys got 20% off. That was the 18 total boxes of the doubleheader, number 3. So in a separate video, guys, you guys will see the hit recap, so you don't have to watch this long 2 hour and 43 minutes now video. So appreciate it, guys. JaspysCaseBreaks.com.